Hello children, welcome to my class. I am Momita and today I'll be doing the story Happy Prince with you. Now Happy Prince is a story about a prince who has died a long time ago. And now when he was living, he never faced any kind of sadness or any kind of sorrow. He never knew what sorrow was. But when he died, a huge statue of his was a life-size statue of his was made. It was well adorned with sapphires. In his eyes he had two sapphires, and in his sword hilt he had a ruby, and all his body was covered with gold leaves, right? And this statue was placed on the main place in the city. On a pedestal means a platform. And now the statue could see everything that happened in his country. He had never seen sadness, but now he always saw sadness. How people suffered from hardship. They were hungry, they had no food, they were without any kind of warmth. And they were dying cold. No one was there to take care of them. The government, the king was not doing anything. Now this thing really, really touched the heart of the Happy Prince. But he was helpless. He couldn't do anything. He was fixed at one place. Now one day it happened so that a little bird flew and sat on its feet. And the Happy Prince could talk with the bird. It expressed its heart's desire to help the people. The bird was actually migrating to Egypt, because in Egypt it was quite warm, and at that place it was cold, and there was a high probability that the bird would die out of cold, right? But the Happy Prince requested him to stay for one day and help a lady, a seamstress. A seamstress is a person who stitches cloth, stitches or irons clothes. Now the Happy Prince wants the swallow to take a ruby, to carry a ruby, carry the ruby which was on the hilt of his sword and give it to the seamstress. Why? The seamstress was extremely poor. She was stitching a dress. She, however, had no money. All the hands, the fingers were pricked with needles. She had no rest, no money. Her son was extremely sick. He was lying on the bed and tossing from one side to another. He wants to have some orange. But the seamstress had nothing to give him except the river water. And the Happy Prince wanted to help this mother, poor mother. So he asked the bird to flew over to the mother and help her with the ruby. So the bird did that. And the next morning, the bird decided that on the same day evening he would fly. So he flew to the Happy Prince to take his permission, and the Happy Prince requested him to stay for one more day, because this time he wants to help a writer who has no fuel, no food. It was getting cold, and the writer could not finish his work due to lack of warmth and food. So it requested the bird to take off one of the sapphire from his eyes. The bird did not agree, but the Happy Prince ordered him to do the same. And as ordered, he also executed the order. He took out a sapphire and flew with it to the Happy Prince. To the writer, and dropped it on the withered violets. There were some dried flowers. He dropped the sapphire there. The writer thought that his writing was being appreciated by people, and the people are trying to help him. But actually, that was not the case. Okay, now that person also his trouble was also solved. Next day, the bird was about to leave. Again, the Happy Prince requested him to stay for one more day, because this time he wanted to help the little match girl who had spoiled all his matchsticks. They were all dropped in the drain. Water, they were all wet, and now if she goes home without any money, the father will beat her. So he wanted the bird to take another sapphire from his other eye and give it to the girl. The bird it did not agree, because if he does that, then the Happy Prince would become completely blind. But as ordered, he had to execute the order. He took out the sapphire and gave it to the girl. Now the bird did not want to leave. He said that he was not going to leave. Why? Because the happy prince had become completely blind now, and it was not possible for him to leave him in this condition. So he decides to stay there until his last breath. Every day he would fly about in the city and bring news about how sad people were. The faces of the children had become white in absence of good food. They were no longer rosier. People had no food. People had no money. They were turned out. They had no home to stay. So every day it was decided that the bird will take off the golden leaves from the happy prince and give it to the poor people. So the town became healthier, happier. People became healthier. People became happier. Now there was no scarcity of dress or food or shelter or warmth. People, the small children, they skated in the ice. But the bird was growing colder and colder. It almost had no food. It tried to keep itself warm by flapping its wings. But this strategy didn't work. One day, the bird understood that his end was very close. He was going to die. So he flew up to the happy prince and requested to kiss him on his hands because he was about to leave. The happy prince thought that he was leaving for Egypt, but actually he was not leaving for Egypt. He was going to the house of death. And thus he kissed the lips of the happy prince, and the happy prince asked him to kiss on his lips because he really loved the bird. So the bird kissed the lips of the happy prince and fell down on his feet. Okay? And in this way he died. And immediately the leaden heart of the happy prince breaks into two. People would think, science would say, that it broke down because of the frost action. But actually, the happy prince also died. Though not died, actually, the soul that was there, its heart also broke. Now, the mayor would come on the next day. It would see the statue in a very shabby condition, and it would be decided that the statue of the happy prince would be pulled down and his statue would be placed in the place of the happy prince, and it would be decorated all over with gold. And moreover, he also said that he would issue an order that birds are not supposed to die there, because he saw the dead bird lying on the feet of the happy prince, right? On the same day, God would ask his angels to bring the two most precious things from the city. And the angel brought the broken heart of the happy prince and the dead bird. And God said that he has chosen rightly, because the happy prince and the bird, they were completely selfless. They always put the interest, they always put the happiness of others before their own selfish ends. One sacrificed his life, the other sacrificed his sight. And finally, he also went out. He also suffered a heartbreak. Right? So, God would decide from then onwards, both the happy prince and the bird, they will stay with him in his heaven, because they were selfless creatures who loved the creations of God. And thus the story ends here. Now let us read the chapter line wise, so that you can have a better understanding of the chapter. You can understand the meaning. That's it. So let's start with the chapter. Now let us start the story, The Happy Prince. Now, high above the city, on a tall column, stood the statue of the happy prince. He was gilded all over with thin leaves of gold. For eyes he had two bright sapphires, and a large red ruby glowed on his sword hilt. Now this is the description of the happy prince. How was he? Where was he erected? The statue of happy prince stood on a tall column. And he was gilded all over with thin leaves of fine gold, and he had two sapphires on his two eyes, and then there was a large red ruby which glowed on his sword hilt.
One night there flew over a city a little swallow. His friends had gone to Egypt 6 weeks before, but he had stayed behind. Then he decided to go to Egypt too. Now, one night in the city came the little swallow. All his friends had gone to Egypt and he was left behind. But later he decided that he must also go to Egypt. And all day long he flew, and at night time he arrived at the city. "Where shall I put up?" he said. "I hope the town has made preparations." Then he saw the statue on the tall column. Now, the swallow did not know where to stay. He needed a shelter. And the whole city had made preparation. Preparation of what? Preparation of the winter festival, right? "And I will put up there," he cried. "It is a fine position with plenty of fresh air." So he alighted just between the feet of the happy prince. Alighted means came and sat down. Now he thought that would be a fine place. So he came and sat down between the feet of the happy prince. "I have a golden bedroom," he said softly to himself as he looked around and the and prepared to go to sleep. But just as he was putting his head under his large wing, a large drop of water fell on him. Now just as he was about to sleep, what happened? A drop of water fell on him. "What a curious thing," he cried. "There's not a single cloud in the sky. The stars are quite clear and bright, and yet it is raining." Now he thought that it's a very curious thing. The sky is clear, there is no cloud at all, and yet how is it possible that yet it is raining? Then another drop fell. "What is the use of this statue if it cannot keep the rain off?" he said. "I must look for a good chimney pot," and he determined to fly away. So he said that the statue was of no use. He concluded that the statue was of no use because it could not keep the rain off. So he was determined, he decided to fly away. But before he had opened his wings, a third drop fell. And he looked up and saw, ah, what did I see? The eyes of the happy prince were filled with tears. And tears were running down his golden cheek. His face was so beautiful in the moonlight that the little swallow was filled with pity. Now, when he lifted his head, he saw that the happy prince was crying and tears were running down his golden cheek, and his face was so very beautiful in the moonlight that the happy prince was filled with pity for him. "Who are you?" he said. "I am the happy prince." "Why are you weeping then?" asked the swallow. Now, when the swallow asked who he was, the statue replied that he was happy prince. Now, the bird asked in wonder, "Then why are you weeping?" asked the swallow. "You have quite drenched me." Drenched me means made me wet. He said that you have made me wet. "When I was alive and had a human heart," answered the statue, "I did not know what tears were, for I lived in the palace where sorrow is not allowed to enter." And he said that when he was alive and he was living, that is when he was not yet dead, he had a human heart and he lived in the palace, and he never knew what sorrow was, because in the palace, in the protected atmosphere of the palace, sorrow was not allowed to enter. "My courtiers called me the happy prince, and happy indeed I was. So I lived and so I died." So he was always happy when he was living, and when he died, then also he was happy. "And now that I am dead, they have set me up here so high that I can see the ugliness and all the misery of my city. And though my heart is made of lead, yet I cannot choose but weep." Now he says that now after his death, his statue is placed on a high column. And from where he could see the ugliness and misery of the city, the sadness that prevails in his city. And though he says that though his heart is made up of lead, yet it can feel the suffering of the people and it cannot stop crying. "What? Is he not solid gold?" said the swallow to himself. He was too polite to ask any, to make any personal remarks. Now, the bird wondered that the bird had thought that it was made of solid gold. Now, he said that was it not solid gold? Now, the bird was too polite to make ask the question. Far away, continued the statue in a low musical tone. In the little street, there is a poor house. One of the windows is open, and through it, I can see a woman seated at the table. Her face is thin and worn, and she has coarse red hair, all pricked by the needle, for she is a seamstress. The word seamstress means a person who irons and stitches clothes. Now, the happy prince says that far away, across the away in the little street, he could see a poor house, and through the open window he could see a woman who was seated on a table, and she is a seamstress. She seems to be stitching something, and all her everywhere throughout his entire hands has become red, and they are pricked with needle. She is embroidering flowers on satin gown for the loveliest of the queen's maid of honor. Queen's maid of honor refers to the queen's attendant. Main personal attendant. What is she doing? She is stitching a satin gown for the queen's personal assistant, and she is going to wear it in the next court ball. In the bed, in a bed in the corner of the room, her little boy is lying ill. He has fever and is asking his mother to give him oranges. His mother has nothing to give him but river water, so he is crying. Swallow, swallow, little swallow. Will you not bring her the ruby out of my sword hilt? My feet are fastened to this pedestal. I cannot move. So he asks the swallow to help him. He says, he requests the swallow to carry the ruby to the house and help the poor mother to give medicine and food to the child. I am waited for in the Egypt, said the swallow. My friends are flying up and down the Nile and talking to the large lotus flowers. Soon they will go to sleep. That is, they would. Going to sleep refers to hibernate. Now she says that soon they will go to sleep. That is, they would go to hibernation. Right. The prince asked the swallow to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. The boy is so thirsty and the mother is so sad, he said. Now the prince requests the swallow to stay with him for one night and help the mother and the boy, who is sick and thirsty but has nothing to eat or drink except river water. I don't think I like boys, answered the swallows. I want to go to Egypt. He said that he doesn't like boys because, as you know, the boys are very naughty. They throw stones at birds. And he said, the bird says that he doesn't like boys, and also stresses the fact that he wants to go to Egypt. But the happy prince looked so sad that the little swallow was sorry. It was very cold here, he said, but he agreed to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. Now, though it was cold, he decided to stay there because the happy prince seemed to be very sad. Looking at his sad face, he had some pity on him, and he decided that he would stay with one more night with the happy prince. Thank you, little swallow, said the prince. The swallow picked out the great ruby from the prince's sword and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. He passed by the cathedral tower where the white marble angels were sculptured. He passed by the palace. He heard the sound of dancing. A beautiful girl came out on the balcony with her lover. I hope my dress will be ready in time for the state ball, she said. I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it, but the seamstresses are so lazy. Now just see what happens here. The little bird takes out the ruby from the sword and flies and over the roofs of the town. He wants to reach that house. He passes the cathedral tower and where the white marble angels were sculpted, and then he passed the palace where he heard the sound of dancing, and soon came out a beautiful girl with her lover. And she says that I hope my dress will be ready in time. And she also complains that the seamstresses are so lazy. But in real condition, she does not understand. She does not understand the reality. What problem she is suffering from. Her child is sick. He wants an orange. And the seamstress has no money to give that. Her hands are all pricked over with needle, yet she is walking. This cannot be laziness, right? He passed over the rivers and saw the lanterns hanging on the masts of the ship. At last he came to the poor woman's house and looked in. The boy was tossing. Tossing means moving from one side to another, feverishly on his bed. And the mother had fallen asleep. She was so tired. So when he entered, the boy was tossing from one side to another and the mother had fallen asleep. In he hopped and laid the great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble. Thimble is a kind of guard that protects your thumb while you sew. It is a metal protection. It is a metal covering or a metal protection. Metal protector that protects your thumb while you are sewing something. Then he flew gently round the bed, fanning the boy's forehead with his wings. How cool I feel, said the boy. I must be getting better. Now when the birds flew around the bed and fanned the boy's forehead, he felt better. It was cold and he started feeling better. And he sank into a delicious slumber. Slumber means a deep sleep. He again slept. Then the swallow flew back to the happy prince and told him what he had done. It is curious, he remarked, but I feel quite warm now, though it is so cold. Now this generally happens when you do something good. Good deed brings you happiness. Now he says that though it is cold, I am feeling warm, I am so happy. This is because you have done a good action, said the prince. And the little swallow began to think and then fell asleep. Thinking always made him sleepy. When the day broke, he flew down the river and had a bath. Tonight I go to Egypt, said the swallow now. In the morning, he went to the river and took a bath, and then he said that today night he was going to Egypt, said the swallow. And he was in high spirits at this idea of going to Egypt. He was feeling very nice. He visited all the when the moon rose, he flew back. He visited all the monuments and sat a long time on the top of the church steeple. He sat on the church steeple for a long time. When the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. Have you any commissions for Egypt? He cried. I'm just starting now. He said that he asked the happy prince if he has any work in Egypt. He was just flying then. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Will you stay with me one night longer? I'm waited for in Egypt, answered the swallow. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Far away across the city, I see a young man in a garret. He is leaning over his desk covered with papers, and in the glass by his side there is a bunch of withered violets. His hair is brown and crisp, and his lips are red as pomegranate, and he has large and dreamy eyes. He is trying to finish a play for the director of the theater, but he is too cold to write any play for the director of the theater. But he is too cold to write anymore. There is no fire in the grate, and hunger has made him faint. Now this time the happy prince wants the bird to help a writer who cannot write because there was neither fuel nor food in his room. And he was becoming extremely sick. He had almost fainted. He had grown so weak. I'll wait with you one night longer, said the swallow, who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. Alas, I have no ruby now, said the prince. My eyes are all that I have left. They are made of rare sapphires, which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago. Now this time, the bird again agreed to stay for one night longer. And he asked the happy prince to give him another ruby so that he might help the writer. But the happy prince had no more rubies left. So he said that now he could offer him one of his eyes, which are made up of rare sapphire, which are very costly, very precious, and they were brought from India 1,000 years ago. He ordered the swallow to pluck out one of them and take it to the playwright. He will sell it to the jeweler and buy firewood and finish his play, he said. Dear prince, said the swallow, I cannot do that, he began to weep. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. Now this time the prince commanded the swallow as a king. He said that you have to do as I am commanding you, because I am the king. And what was the command? To carry one of his eyes, that is the sapphire, to the poet so that he can sell it and buy firewood and fuel. So the swallow plucked out the prince's eyes and flew away to the young man's garret. Garret is a small room on the roof. It was easy enough to get in, as there was a hole in the roof. Though through this he darted. Darted means to move very swiftly. Darted means to move very swiftly. There was a hole in the roof, and very easily the bird flew in inside the room. The young man had his head buried in his hands, so he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wing. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire lying on the withered violets. Violets refer to the flower. There were a bunch of violets on the table which had withered. So when the writer woke up, he saw the sapphire kept on the violets, and he even could not hear the fluttering of the bird's wing because he was extremely tired to look up. And he had also his head was also buried in his hand. So neither did he hear nor did he see the bird coming in through the hole. What did the poet think then? The poet thought that it was a gift from one of his admirers. He said, I'm beginning to be appreciated, he cried. This is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play. And he looked quite happy. The next day, the swallow flew down to the harbor. He sat on the mast of the large vessel and watched the sailors working. I'm going to Egypt, cried the swallow, but nobody minded. And when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. Next morning he was very happy. He had finished his work, and now on the same day he would be flying off to Egypt. He saw the sailors working he sat on the mast of a large ship, and he saw the sailors who were working. He shouted to them that he was out of his excitement. He shouted to them that he was going to Egypt the same day, but no one cared for him. And then he flew back when the moon rose. When it was evening, he flew back to the happy prince. I have come to bid you goodbye, he cried. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, will you not stay with me one night longer? It is winter, answered the swallow, and the snow will soon be here. In Egypt, the sun is warm, and the green palm trees, and the crocodiles lie in the mud and look lazily about them in the square below. Now he said, what did the bird say? That it was very soon it would be snowing there, and he would die out of cold. And in Egypt the weather is fine. The sun is shining with all its warmth on the green palm trees, and the crocodiles are basking in the sun, in the mud, and they are looking about lazily. But the happy prince did not pay any heed to what the bird was saying. He was more concerned about the pain of the poor, about the pain of the helpless. What did he say? In the square below, said the happy prince, there stands a little match girl. She has let her matches fall in the gutter. Now the happy prince could see a match girl who had spoiled all her matches because they were fallen in the gutter. Her father will beat her if she does not bring home some money. And she's crying. There is no shoes nor stockings, and her little head is bare. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her, and her father will not beat her. Now see how selfless this happy prince is. The happy prince said that the bird is supposed to pluck out the other eye to help the poor match girl so that she does not get a thrashing from her father. "I will stay with you one night longer," said the swallow. "But I cannot pluck out your eye. You would be quite blind then." "Swallow, swallow, little swallow," said the prince, "do as I command you." So he plucked out the prince's other's eye and darted down. Darted means the same thing. Move with great speed with it. He swooped. Swoop means he came down past the match girl. So he came down. He came very close to the match girl on the ground and slipped the jewels into the palm of her hand. "What a lovely bit of glass," cried the little girl, and she ran home laughing. She was very happy to get the lovely piece of glass, so she ran home laughing. Then the swallow came back to the prince. "You are blind now," he said, "so I will stay with you always." "No, little swallow," said the poor prince, "you must go away to Egypt." "No, I will stay with you always," said the swallow, and he slept at the prince's feet. Now, the swallow was also a selfless person. As the happy prince has sacrificed his sight, his eyes, for the poor people, similarly, the bird was also ready to serve his life for the happy prince. He was not ready to leave the happy prince under such a circumstance. When the happy prince had become completely blind, he had given both his eyes to poor people. So the bird decided to stay with the happy prince forever. All the next day he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in strange land. As you know, the swallow was a migratory bird, he had seen so many things, and he narrated all the tales of strange lands to the happy prince sitting on his shoulder. "Dear little swallow," said the prince, "you tell me of marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery." Now this is something very great, the happy prince says. The happy prince tells him that you are telling me something very marvelous about marvelous things. But he believes that the most marvelous thing is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery. Misery means poverty. Tough condition, wretched condition. It says that the people live such a miserable life, and this is a mystery. This is the greatest of all the mysteries. "Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you see there." So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses, while the beggars were sitting at the gates. Now he saw how painful life could be. He saw how the rich men were celebrating in their beautiful houses, and the beggars were sitting at the gates in hope of getting some food. He flew into the dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly. Listlessly means without any energy. They did not seem, the children seems to have no energy. The children seem to have no energy because they do not get proper food and nutrition. And they were looking at the black streets. See the color chosen, white, black. So their life, the life of the poor is also colorless. Blacks and always in blacks and whites and gray. Under the archway of the building, two little boys were lying at each other's arms to try and keep themselves warm. "How hungry we are," they said. "You must not lie here," shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. Now there were two little boys who were feeling so cold. They had no warm clothes. They were trying to keep themselves warm by lying in each other's arm. And they were also very hungry. They were saying that they were very hungry. And at that instant, a watchman came and shouted at them that they must not lie there. And they wandered away. They moved out into the rain in that cold and hunger. They suffered cold and hunger. Such a miserable life they had. Then he flew back and told the happy prince what he had seen. "I'm covered with cold," said the prince. "You must take it off leaf by leaf and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy." So when the bird reported everything to the happy prince asked the bird to carry the golden leaves which covered his body. and he also told him to give the poor give each of the poor family one of his leaves, so that they can also buy the various things necessary for a comfortable life. And he said that the living being always think that gold can make them happy. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold the swallow picked off, till the happy prince looked quite dull and gray. Now, when all the gold leaves disappeared, when the sapphires were not there, the ruby was also gone, the happy prince looked dull and gray. Leaf after leaf of fine gold he brought to the poor, and the children's face grew rosier, and they laughed and played in the street. Now, with every passing day, the poor people became rich. How? Because now they had money, they got those golden leaves, and now the faces of the young, the small children were no longer white, they became rosier, and they laughed and played about in the street. We have bread now, they cried. And then the snow came, and after the snow came the frost. The street looked as if they were made of silver. Everybody went about in furs, and little boys wore scarlet caps. Scarlet means red. Now see the color here. There is no more white and black and gray. You will see red, rosy color, scarlet. Scarlet also means red. And they skated on the ice, because now they had warm clothes. Their life was easier. Their lives were happy. They were no longer in such a miserable state. The poor little swallow got colder and colder. But he would not leave the prince. He was very loyal to the prince. He got colder and colder. There was not sufficient food. He was feeling very cold. But yet, it did not leave the happy prince. He picked up crumbs outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking, and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. But at last he knew that he was going to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the prince's shoulder once more. So he flew up to the prince's shoulder once more and said, "Goodbye, dear happy prince," he murmured. "Will you let me kiss your hand? I'm glad that you are going to..." Now, for the last time, the bird wanted to kiss the hand of the happy prince. Now, the happy prince thought that the bird has finally agreed to go to Egypt, but it was not that. He had come to say the final goodbye, because he was saying a final goodbye from his life. He was going to die. He knew it very well. "I'm glad that you are going to Egypt at last, little swallow," said the prince. "You have stayed too long here, but you may kiss on my lips, for I love you." "It's not Egypt that I'm going," said the swallow. "I'm going to the house of death. Death is the brother of sleep, is it not?" Now he said that, "No, happy prince, you were wrong. I'm not going to any Egypt." Now he said that he was going to die, and he also said he compared death to sleep, and he said that death and sleep, they are two brothers. And he kissed the happy prince on the lips and fell down dead at his feet. At that moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue, as if something has broken. The fact is that the leaden heart had snapped right into two. The word snapped means broken, separated, divided. So when the bird died, at the same instant, there was a strange sound coming from inside the statue. It was the leaden heart of the happy prince that had broken into two. It certainly was a dreadfully hard frost. Now, people might think the lead heart broke because of the frost. "I'll wait with you one night longer," said the swallow, who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. "Alas, I have no ruby now," said the prince. "My eyes are all that I have left. They are made of rare sapphires, which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago." Now this time, the bird again agreed to stay for one night longer. And he asked the happy prince to give him another ruby so that he might help the writer. But the happy prince had no more rubies left. So he said that now he could offer him one of his eyes, which are made up of rare sapphire, which are very costly, very precious, and they were brought from India 1,000 years ago. He ordered the swallow to pluck out one of them and take it to the playwright. He will sell it to the jeweler and buy firewood and finish his play, he said. Dear prince, said the swallow, I cannot do that, he began to weep. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. Now this time the prince commanded the swallow as a king. He said that you have to do as I am commanding you because I am the king. And what was the command? To carry one of his eyes, that is the sapphire, to the poet so that he can sell it and buy firewood and fuel. So the swallow plucked out the prince's eyes and flew away to the young man's garret. Garret is a small room on the roof. It was easy enough to get in as there was a hole in the roof. Though through this he darted. Darted means to move very swiftly. Darted means to move very swiftly. There was a hole in the roof and very easily the bird flew in inside the room. The young man had his head buried in his hands, so he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wing. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire lying on the withered violets. Violets refer to the flower. There were a bunch of violets on the table which had withered. So when the writer woke up, he saw the sapphire kept on the violets, and he even could not hear the fluttering of the bird's wing because he was extremely tired to look up. And he had also his head was also buried in his hand. So neither did he hear nor did he see the bird coming in through the hole. What did the poet think then? The poet thought that it was a gift from one of his admirers. He said, I'm beginning to be appreciated, he cried. This is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play. And he looked quite happy. The next day, the swallow flew down to the harbor. He sat on the mast of the large vessel and watched the sailors working. I'm going to Egypt, cried the swallow, but nobody minded. And when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. Next morning, he was very happy. He had finished his work and now, on the same day, he would be flying off to Egypt. He saw the sailors working he sat on the mast of a large ship and he saw the sailors who were working. He shouted to them that he was out of his excitement. He shouted to them that he was going to Egypt the same day, but no one cared for him. And then he flew back when the moon rose. When it was evening, he flew back to the happy prince. I've come to bid you goodbye, he cried. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, will you not stay with me one night longer? It is winter, answered the swallow, and the snow will soon be here. In Egypt, the sun is warm, and the green palm trees, and the crocodiles lie in the mud and look lazily about them in the square below. Now he said, what did the bird say? That it was very soon it would be snowing there and he would die out of cold. And in Egypt the weather is fine. The sun is shining with all its warmth on the green palm trees and the crocodiles are basking in the sun, in the mud, and they are looking about lazily. But the happy prince did not pay any heed to what the bird was saying. He was more concerned about the pain of the poor. About the pain of the helpless. What did he say? In the square below, said the happy prince, there stands a little match girl. She has let her matches fall in the gutter. Now the happy prince could see a match girl who had spoiled all her matches because they were fallen in the gutter. Her father will beat her if she does not bring home some money. And she's crying. There is no shoes nor stockings and her little head is bare. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her, and her father will not beat her. Now see how selfless this happy prince is. The happy prince said that the bird is supposed to pluck out the other eye to help the poor match girl so that she does not get a thrashing from her father. I will stay with you one night longer, said the swallow. But I cannot pluck out your eye. You would be quite blind then.
Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Do as I command you. So he plucked out the prince's other eye and darted down. Darted means the same thing. Move with great speed with it. He swooped. Swoop means he came down past the match girl. So he came down. He came very close to the match girl on the ground and slipped the jewels into the palm of her hand.
What a lovely bit of glass, cried the little girl. And she ran home laughing. She was very happy to get the lovely piece of glass. So she ran home laughing.
Then the swallow came back to the prince. You are blind now, he said. So I will stay with you always.
No, little swallow, said the poor prince. You must go away to Egypt.
No, I will stay with you always, said the swallow. And he slept at the prince's feet.
Now, the swallow was also a selfless person. As the happy prince has sacrificed his sight, his eyes, for the poor people. Similarly, the bird was also ready to serve his life for the happy prince. He was not ready to leave the happy prince under such a circumstance. When the happy prince had become completely blind, he had given both his eyes to poor people. So the bird decided to stay with the happy prince forever.
All the next day he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in strange land. As you know, the swallow was a migratory bird, he had seen so many things, and he narrated all the tales of strange lands to the happy prince sitting on his shoulder.
Dear little swallow, said the prince, you tell me of marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery. Now this is something very great, the happy prince says. The happy prince tells him that you are telling me something very marvelous about marvelous things. But he believes that the most marvelous thing is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery. Misery means poverty. Tough condition, wretched condition. He says that the people live such a miserable life, and this is a mystery. This is the greatest of all the mysteries. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you see there. So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses, while the beggars were sitting at the gates. Now he saw how painful life could be. He saw how the rich men were celebrating in their beautiful houses, and the beggars were sitting at the gates in hope of getting some food. He flew into the dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly. Listlessly means without any energy. They did not seem, the children seems to have no energy. The children seem to have no energy because they do not get proper food and nutrition. And they were looking at the black streets. See the color chosen, white, black. So their life, the life of the poor is also colorless. Blacks and always in blacks and whites and gray. Under the archway of the building, two little boys were lying at each other's arms to try and keep themselves warm. How hungry we are, they said. You must not lie here, shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. Now there were two little boys who were feeling so cold. They had no warm clothes. They were trying to keep themselves warm by lying in each other's arm. And they were also very hungry. They were saying that they were very hungry. And at that instant, a watchman came and shouted at them that they must not lie there. And they wandered away. They moved out into the rain in that cold and hunger. They suffered cold and hunger. Such a miserable life they had. Then he flew back and told the happy prince what he had seen. I'm covered with cold, said the prince. You must take it off leaf by leaf and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy. So when the bird reported everything to the happy prince asked the bird to carry the golden leaves which covered his body. And he also told him to give the poor give each of the poor family one of his leaves, so that they can also buy the various things necessary for a comfortable life. And he said that the living being always think that gold can make them happy. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold, the swallow picked off, till the happy prince looked quite dull and grey. Now, when all the gold leaves disappeared, when the sapphires were not there, the ruby was also gone, the happy prince looked dull and grey. Leaf after leaf of fine gold he brought to the poor, and the children's face grew rosier, and they laughed and played in the street. Now, with every passing day, the poor people became rich. How? Because now they had money. They got those golden leaves, and now the faces of the young, the small children were no longer white. They became rosier, and they laughed and played about in the street. "We have bread now," they cried. And then the snow came, and after the snow came the frost. The street looked as if they were made of silver. Everybody went about in furs, and little boys wore scarlet caps. Scarlet means red. Now see the color here. There is no more white and black and gray. You will see red, rosy color, scarlet. Scarlet also means red. And they skated on the ice, because now they had warm clothes. Their life was easier. Their lives were happy. They were no longer in such a miserable state. The poor little swallow got colder and colder. But he would not leave the prince. He was very loyal to the prince. He got colder and colder. There was not sufficient food. He was feeling very cold. But yet, it did not leave the happy prince. He picked up crumbs outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking, and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. But at last, he knew that he was going to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the prince's shoulder once more. So he flew up to the prince's shoulder once more and said, "Goodbye, dear happy prince," he murmured. "Will you let me kiss your hand? I'm glad that you are going to..." Now, for the last time, the bird wanted to kiss the hand of the happy prince. Now, the happy prince thought that the bird has finally agreed to go to Egypt, but it was not that. He had come to say the final goodbye, because he was saying a final goodbye from his life. He was going to die. He knew it very well. "I'm glad that you are going to Egypt at last, little swallow," said the prince. "You have stayed too long here, but you may kiss on my lips, for I love you." "It's not Egypt that I'm going," said the swallow. "I'm going to the house of death. Death is the brother of sleep, is he not?" Now he said that, "No, happy prince, you were wrong. I'm not going to any Egypt." Now he said that he was going to die, and he also said he compared death to sleep, and he said that death and sleep, they are two brothers. And he kissed the happy prince on the lips and fell down dead at his feet. At that moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue, as if something has broken. The fact is that the leaden heart had snapped right into two. The word snapped means broken, separated, divided. So when the bird died, at the same instant, there was a strange sound coming from inside the statue. It was the leaden heart of the happy prince that had broken into two. It certainly was a dreadfully hard frost. Now, people might think the lead heart broke because of the frost.